Now, before we create our very first chat flow, let's have a look at the Flowise UI. The first thing I like to do after setting up Flowise is to enable dark mode, as I hate blinding myself or my audience. On the left-hand menu, we have different options to create chat flows, agent flows, and assistants. We will cover each of these options in the course, but in a nutshell, we can use chat flows to create things like conversational chatbots, AI agents, or assistants. With agent flows, we can take it a step further by creating flows that contain multiple agents that can work together to solve complex tasks. In the assistants menu, we can easily create assistants which contain custom knowledge bases and tools by effectively following a very simple wizard. So most of the work is done for you in the background. Within Marketplace, we can search for existing templates that we can simply copy over to our own namespace and change as we see fit. So here we can see examples of document Q&A chatbots, agentic RAG, and a whole bunch of other very cool examples. Of course, we will be creating everything from scratch. Within the Tools menu, we can create our very own tools, or we can also go to the Marketplace and look for any existing tools and then copy these tools over to our own namespace. Or if we click on Create, we can create our very own tools by writing some JavaScript code. Within the Credentials menu, we can see all the credentials that we've stored in Flowise. These will contain things like our connection details to OpenAI or Anthropic, or our vector stores. So this is a very elegant solution for maintaining all the credentials in a centralized place. We can also set global variables within the variable menu, and each of our flows will have access to these variables. Within the API key menu, we can create and view our API keys. Flowise offers a massive list of APIs that you can call from outside of the platform in order to interact with your flows or even make changes to your flows. And in order to use those APIs, you do need to authenticate the API call with an API key. Lastly, we can use the Document Stores menu to create our very own knowledge bases, and our AI agents will have access to these document stores. We will spend a lot of time in this menu soon. Before we create any of our chat flows, we need to decide on which large language model we're going to use for this tutorial course. These large language models are effectively the brains for these AI chat flows. Now, giving you advice on what to use in this tutorial can be very tricky, because I know there will be those of you who are not willing to spend any money to use services like OpenAI or Anthropic, and you would prefer to use free services. So I will give you some advice on those free services and what to use and what to avoid. But I'm personally going to use OpenAI during the course of the series. So for those of you who would prefer to use free models, this is what you can do. If you're running Flowise locally and you have the hardware to do so, then you can use something called Ollama to run open source models directly on your machine. I have a dedicated video on my channel discussing how to set up Ollama and use it within Flowise. So this is just going to be a brief explanation on how to do that, but if you do get stuck, then check out that video, which I will link in the description of this video. But in a nutshell, go to ollama.com, download Ollama for your operating system, and install it. Then you can go to the Models page and look up a model like Llama 3.2, then copy this command, open up your command prompt or terminal, then paste in that command and press enter. This will download the model, and afterwards you should be able to test it by sending a message. And this means we can now use this model in our Flowise applications free of charge. And this is completely local. If you don't have the hardware to run those models locally, then I highly recommend using Grok. This service is also free to use, and this also allows you to run open source models. To set this up, go to grok.com and click on Dev Console. From here, go to API Keys, create a new key, give it a name like Flowise Tutorial, click on Submit, copy this key, and back in Flowise, go to Credentials, click on Add Credential, search for Grok, select Grok API, paste in that key, and we can just give this credential a name like Grok API. And let's click on Add. But I do want to mention that Grok does give you access to open source models like Llama 3.3. Now, I do want to mention the caveats with using these free open source models. The first caveat is with Ollama, and specifically this Llama 3.2 model. Yes, Ollama also has support for Llama 3.3. However, this is a massive model and it's about 43 gigs to download. The chances are that the majority of you will not have the hardware to run this model. So, you will pretty much be limited to run Llama 3.2, the 3 billion parameter model. Most hardware will be able to run this model. These small models are more than capable of handling things like chatbots or very simple agents. But once we start building multi-agent flows, you will run into issues. For the multi-agent flows, I definitely recommend a way more intelligent model like the Llama 3.3 model, in which case you might want to use Grok instead. However, Grok comes with its own shortcomings. In order for Grok to be free, they have to enforce rate limiting. So it's very possible that your flow will just simply stop working because you've technically hit your rate limit. So as much as people don't like hearing this, I do recommend using a paid service like Anthropic or OpenAI for learning how to build AI applications. It's just not worth it, in my opinion, to try and get some free model to function as opposed to simply learning how to build these applications without all that friction. So what I recommend you do is go to platform.openai.com and sign up for an account. You will need to load some credit onto your account. So all you have to do is go to your profile, click on billing, and then add some credit to your account. This can be as little as $5. Then once you've added some credit, go back to your dashboard, click on API keys, click on create new secret key. Let's give it a name like Flowise tutorial. Let's click on create secret key. Let's copy the key. Then back in Flowise, let's add the credential. Let's search for OpenAI. Let's paste in the API key. And let's give our credential a name like OpenAI API. So I'll show you how to get the Anthropic API key as well. Go to anthropic.com/API and click on start building. You can then sign into your account or create an account. And this might have changed as well, but I think Anthropic might give you free credit. But if they don't, simply click on your profile, click on billing, and you can add credit from the screen by completing the setup. And as you can see, I still have credit left without having to complete my setup process. So I suspect they do give you free credit, and for some reason this credit lasts a very long time. Once you have some credit loaded, go back to your dashboard, click on get API keys, click on create key, let's give it a name like Flowise tutorial, let's copy this key, then back in Flowise, let's add credential, let's search for Anthropic API, let's paste in that key. And for the name, I'll just call it Anthropic API. I suggest just picking one of these. Maybe you can start with Grok because it is free. And the moment you run into issues, consider signing up for Anthropic, as I think they might give you free credits. Or alternatively, add some credit to your OpenAI account and use your OpenAI models instead. Now that we have our large language model credential set up, we can go ahead and build our very first Flowise project.